Good evening, everyone. I want to thank you all for coming to the celebration of the music of Al Lee Pack. The concert's been a couple years in the making. It was an idea that Sal Raniello and I had and been talking about, and this was definitely the right time to do it. So I want to thank Sal for all of his help. Unfortunately, he was unable to make it, but he was an integral part of the planning for this evening's event. Looking around on the stage, and some of you alumni have visited Mr. Lee Pack's studio. You've heard some of the students play. And I just want to remind everybody that everything you hear tonight, everything you see happen, is because of Mr. Lee Pack's vision. And this wouldn't exist if it weren't for him. So we've placed the plaque on the door to the studio to remind us of where we come from and who started our program. We talk about Mr. Lee Pack in our percussion history class because he, in fact, is a very important part of percussion history, and it's important that all of the students that come through this building have an understanding and appreciation for his contribution to the percussive arts. I really feel like we are the stewards of his program. We're just taking care of it until the next percussion teacher comes along. I first met Mr. Lee Pack on the day that I auditioned for the job here. I knew all about him, of course. You know, I knew his name since I was in junior high school and played his music since I was in junior high school. But I finally met him on the day that I auditioned for this job, which was in 1992. And afterwards he came up to me and it was kind of hard to read him. He had a kind of a poker face, you know, and he said, "Well," I'm not actually on the committee that's going to make this decision, but I want you to know that you're my choice. And with all due respect to David McBride and Roger Murtha and all the people that were on the committee, Mr. Lepak's opinion meant a hell of a lot more than theirs. And I felt great. I remember driving home, you know, I didn't know for some weeks whether I got the job or not. I didn't really care. I was so flattered and thrilled that he said that to me. I knew from the moment that I met him that I was in the presence of greatness, and I'll never forget that meeting. He also came back and did some teaching. You know, we have a guest teacher rotation here at the Hart School. One of our illustrious alumni, Joe Galeota, is part of that rotation. He teaches African drumming, and we also study Cuban and Haitian and Brazilian and Middle Eastern percussion, but Mr. Lepak did it twice as well and taught timpani and other things to the students, which was a joy for all of us. And we actually presented a very similar concert some years ago and he conducted it. And I'll tell you just a short story about that concert. First of all, he came into the room and every tempo that was marked on the page, if the students weren't sure what the tempo was, he somehow could pull it out of thin air. He seemed to be like a walking metronome. And we all know that he had A 440 memorized. And the first thing he asked the guys at every lesson was, "Okay, sing an A." So they were walking around with tuning forks, you know, every day trying to master that skill. So the concert comes around with all this music. And it turns out that that week he was suffering rather severely from kidney stones. And I didn't think he was going to make it. You know, he could hardly walk up onto the stage. So got a stool, timpani stool for him, and he came and sat down. I don't know how he did it. He conducted the whole concert. And afterwards, I was talking to Sal about it, and I really didn't think he was going to make it. I was actually waiting in the wings with the scores in case I had to conduct. And Sal said, "Man, once you're a tough old Marine, you're always a tough old Marine." And there was no way he wasn't going to conduct that concert. It was very inspiring. You know that he began teaching here shortly after World War II, teaching percussion and some jazz band directing and ear training, other things, on sort of a part-time basis as early as 1947, and he was full-time in 1950. And that really makes us the first percussion program in the country. Something we're very proud of, and I'm honored by the fact that since 1947, in essence, he and I are the only two people that have taught here. His accomplishments, as you know, I don't need to tell all of you, are quite varied as a performer, a percussionist, timpanist, drum set player, publisher, composer, conductor, and a world-class teacher as well. Shortly after getting the job, you know, I went to one of the percussion conventions, one of the international conventions. It was just a couple months, actually, after I started working here. And the first thing I became very aware of was that all of his former students, they loved him and they revered him like I had never seen. I've never seen students look up to their teacher like that. And without exception, that's been the response I've gotten from every alumnus I've ever met who worked with Mr. Lipak. In essence, through his work with the percussion department and the jazz department and music theory department, he inspired generations of musicians. There's no doubt about it, which is actually, in my opinion, even more important than all of his accolades as a player, is the inspiration that he spread. But it was even more moving to learn about what inspired him. And you all know that that's his beloved Charlotte, who's here tonight. I want to thank you for coming. Thank you for everything, for all these years. Mrs. Lipak has been an integral part of our department, not just by supporting Mr. Lipak, but by supporting the students, and you all know how good her chili tastes, right? So I'd like to ask Janine, who is the current studio mom, my girl, to bring out a little present for Mrs. Lipak. So thank you, Mrs. Lipak, for coming. Thank you, alumni, for coming. Thank you, everyone, for coming. We're going to continue with, we have some snare drum duets. We have some solo music this evening. Of course, we have his quintet. I guess the last thing I'll say is that, you know, I worked with the students on this music quite a bit in the fall, and more recently, Elliot, who's, I'm on a sabbatical right now, by the way. And my replacement is a former student of mine named Elliot Wallace, who's done a wonderful job working with the students, fine-tuning everything for this concert. And I've kind of poked my head in occasionally the past couple of few weeks. And you know, for me, when I sit in the room and listen to Mr. Lipak's music, I feel his presence. His music is so distinct, you know, you all know this, and it's so personal. I really feel connected to him. I feel like he's there. And I hope that you get a little bit of that yourself this evening. Thank you very much. While we make the last few set up adjustments for crescendo, I just want to take this opportunity to first I want to thank Aiden, the bass player that helped us out in the last two pieces. I also want to thank Elliot again for doing a great job with this concert and the whole semester. I think we should thank all the hard percussion students who clearly worked very hard for this concert. I'd like to thank all of the alumni that came. Some of you are seated here, some of you are joining our dream team here. And thanks for coming. It's been a thrill to see, you know, different generations of hard percussionists working together today. I want to thank all the members of the Lead Pack family that came. It's really thrilling to see everybody here, but in my heart of hearts, this concert was for one person, and I'm so glad that you're here. After this piece, please join us in the reception. You can say hello to Mrs. Lipak and the rest of the family, and we hope you enjoy Crescendo.
Chilnick, and I want to congratulate all the students tonight. Fantastic job. Musicianship, chops, dedication, all that stuff. Fantastic, fantastic job. Some of us were around when he was writing these pieces. He'd say, come on, try this out, try this out. You know, we'd go, oh man, we can't play that. You know, so a lot of years have passed and you have created a great legacy. Ben and Elliot, great job. Where's Ben? Is he here? He's hiding. Why are you hiding? Why are you hiding? Congratulations, I mean, listen, I came all the way from LA. I wanted to have a chance to at least say something, congratulate you. And all my buddies from, you know, we were all kids a long time ago, right? And all working and all playing, and you have a great shoes to follow in. So thanks everybody, and my gosh, all the families and the growing LEPAC families. And Tyler is the youngest, right? Tyler, are you the youngest? Can you say hi? Okay, say hi to your mommy and your daddy, because they're watching you on the internet there. Okay, I just wanted to make sure you knew. Okay, go eat. Thanks, everybody.